restoration project is on course.
It remains sacrosanct.
It is irreversible.
And no amount of force can dampen nor quench.
Answer my prayer. What can I give? You wipe away my tears. Papa, what can I say? You deserve the glory for the things you have done. I'm forever grateful to you. That's why I say.
Championing the cause for the restoration of Biafra. Biafra Human Rights Radio.
Of course, unstoppable and remains the beacon of truth.
It has been so since yesterday.
And it is today and forever. Biafra Restoration Project is on course.
It remains sacrosanct.
It is irreversible.
And no amount of force can dampen nor quench the ingenuity of the indomitable
Biafran spirit.
Yes, sir, once again, fellow Biafrans, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscientious people, wherever you are all over the world, I say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra. Radio Biafra Extra is streaming live from Biafra Land. We are streaming concurrently on Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station. Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station is actually a media platform that is being projected by the de facto customary government of Biafra Land in conjunction with numerous Pool Biafran group, Radio Biafra Human Rights and Freedom radio station is being anchored by Diokpa Uche Okafor-Mefo, who happens to be in charge of information and communication for the de facto customary government. And may I remind you tonight that he is the director of Biafran Nation Alliance. He is from Abatiti. Abatiti is in Anambra State. Anambra State is in Biafra land. Diokpa Uche Okafor-Mefo is the man who has simply assured us that under his watch, he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. And I keep telling you, I do not expect everyone to understand the mindset behind those words, but one day you shall. I want to use this privilege to acknowledge every member of the de facto customary government. First of all, father of the new nation, Chief Raphael Owazurike, the first manufacturer saboteur by Nnamdi Kanu, the hotelian, according to Nnamdi Kanu. But it's almost time for the people of Biafra to know the truth. I respect you, Chief Raphael Owazurike, for your patience, your doggedness, your stability, what you are doing at this moment, and what you shall do tomorrow. You all have made mistakes, but taking responsibility is actually one of the greatest principles of maturity. Chief Alhaji Asare Dokobo, the Chairperson Implementation Committee, Biafran de facto customary government, deputized by our sister, Rita Anebogo, of course, the first female saboteur, original, manufactured by Nnamdi Kanu. But they remain focused because they knew this day will come. And then we must go ahead to acknowledge Uche Nasibu, Uche Nawanonenyi, Umiumiu, Maziu Bidio Bienu, Dr. Okado, Onwazurumba, Nwukinkwo, Dr. Nwukinkwo, Mbadike, Ezekwesile, Okum Okum, Mazi Paul Okinkwo, Brother Chimezie, Bruno, Chukode, Awele, Odogini, Uduwele, Agunwanyi, Ada Biafra, Unyeka, Nkinjika, those who walk in the dark to serve the light. You understand what I mean? Of course, every member of the Biafran Watchmen, sandaled with spiritual responsibility, acknowledge all of you. It doesn't make sense to me when I come on air and then I move ahead as if you are not there. It is all of your presence that has become an inspiration to what I'm doing. And at least when we look back, we see there are people who are still reasoning. We muzzle ourselves with confidence. And then with this great responsibility and understanding that you are there, we march. Tonight, I will also acknowledge the indigenous people of Nnamdi Kanu. They are our brothers, misguided brothers. For the sake of the next generation, we keep giving main emphasis on this issue. It's not as if it is relevant to us. We have outgrown that stage and we are used to their nonchalant characters. The indigenous people of Nnamdi Kanu sometimes hide under the clause that they are the indigenous people of Biafra. This is not true. For the purpose of record keeping, we have numerous IPOB. IPOB led by the DOS, IPOB led by different group, IPOB in Scandinavia, IPOB different place. But the one we are talking about who has become a disease that we must treat is the indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu. It is easy to identify them by their fruit. They curse everybody. They insult everybody. Most especially when you have contrary view or opinion. They know it all. They are led by Nnamdi-Kanu. They also could be referred to as unknown gunmen or ESN. They have killed more Igbo people than any other supposedly imaginary enemy they are fighting. They are the one raping Biafran women and pretending is a Fulani herdsmen, criminals. But am I telling you Fulani herdsmen are not doing their own? It becomes abominable. It becomes a taboo. When you set your people up, you lead them to their death with the guise or with the hope that you are going to attract international sympathy. And then they say, they are killing them. Let's get involved. But for God's sake, to your knowledge, over 10 million people were starved to death. This is genocide. United Nations was there. African Union was there. European Union was there. To mention but a few, they witnessed over the death of 10 million Biafrans. They never showed you sympathy. Is it this we the shoemakers, we the Keke Napepe riders, we the Okada riders? You're the one they think you're going to kill, and then somebody will respond. But it is obvious that what we are fighting for is within the preamble of law. The right to self-determination was first of all God-given. Before there was anything like America, United Nations, or whatever, it is first of all our right. It is enshrined also in their constitution. They recognize it. All we need to do is to follow the process. But the people of Nnamdi-Kanu, indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu, they are just mesmerizing themselves everywhere. I acknowledge you. I see few of you on my platform. Please make haste and tell others that I'm online this evening. Come and insult me. Come and talk rubbish. Because you have no shame. You know nothing of honor. You know nothing of dignity. Nnamdi-Kanu is busy behind closed door bargaining. We are waiting for him. Let him collect amnesty and come out. Anybody who have been selling the next generation, anybody who have been making money on the expense of our people, it doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter who you are. Never again, the one on our do before don't do. You cause problem for us, you feed on the misery of our people, and then you walk away as if nothing happened. You feed everybody with lies. For how long, for God's sake? I acknowledge you, indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu. Misguided people like that. And of course, that having been said, I must move on to acknowledge the Creator, the one who set our feet upon this path that we must follow. Anyi na jage mau nihi na imara mai ihunanya ne nagi ubiomagi o juru anyanya dadio inwe gembangu o di unye di kagi. Ebu wafa no mega anyinini na sina ni de mau ise. And so this evening, like every other evening, without wasting much of our time, we go to our topic, which is simply titled "In Our Ignorance They Control Our Realm." We must therefore not allow them a permanent dominion. And of course, I sometimes prefer taking a long topic for a title. And that is because from reading the topic alone, you'll be able to have an idea where we are driving to. In our ignorance, they control our realm. We must not allow them to have a permanent dominion over our realm. When we try to define realm, for instance, we may end up mystifying our discussion tonight. And so I will want us to look at it from one angle, which simply mean having dominion over a particular areas of interest. Those areas of our interest, as we speak today, is being controlled by the caliphate. Some of those areas we are going to review tonight. In our ignorance, they control our realm completely. The only thing left is for them to exercise that absolute dominion over our. From the supposedly amalgamation of 1940, over 100 years ago to today, Fulani, they have been using all of us. They just throw us on the ground, play us like what? Win us in every game. And our people are not ashamed. Everybody want to be recognized. Everybody want to be respected. Everybody want to be viewed as God. Everybody want to be God. I said the Fulanis, the caliphate, for over 100 years have been playing us as chairs, draft game, and all of them, they win us. All of them, they are winning us and bamboozling us all around. Till now, they control our realm. It doesn't matter who you are. If you are aware of the fact that these people are beating us in our own game, if you are aware of the fact that these people have their neck, their foot on our neck, and you are not ashamed of yourself, and in your own closet, you are not thinking of what we will do to free ourselves from this menace, and then you must be a very wicked individual. But if indeed you've not viewed it that way, and then you are ignorant, may the Lord have mercy upon you. And that is why I say, in our ignorance, because most of you are ignorant, you don't even know what is happening. That is why, as we are speaking now, the ignorant one are busy propelling lies on the social media. Anyway, one madman preach. He said, now the canoe will come out from prison victoriously. Madman now is the one preaching. And you are not ashamed to tell the world that one madman is preaching. And you're not on there, huh? Are we now mad people? We are supposed to be hearing the president of America said so. The president of China said so. Normal president around the globe. We're supposed to hear BBC, CNN. We're supposed to hear every media platform. The voice that matter within the universe. Speak about us. But it's a shame. Ignorant people are telling you now, hey, wait, one madman is preaching Biafra. He's saying now the canoe will come out miraculously. You know, no good sense. Are you deceiving Fulani Janjaweed? Or you are deceiving Yoruba? Or you are deceiving your own people? Who exactly are you deceiving? It's a shame. In the days of ignorance, we allow them to control our realm. Yes, Nigerians suck liar Mohammed because he lied too much. If Nigeria at this stage have to sack liar Mohammed, for your own information, you are supposed to know that they are trying to remove some, they are trying to prevent him from the hammer of justice, law of karma, from catching up to him. Because once you remove him, there'll be no need to question him. There'll be no need to prove him in the picture. He will disappear as if he never existed. In the next Fulani government, he will still emerge. If Buhari can deliberately give appointment to dead people, dead ministers who work with him before now, he still gave them appointment. Is it liar Muhammad you are telling me? But it's your ignorance. And Yari just saying, hey, yes, they have removed him. Is Fulani removing him for our own good? Anyway, Nandekano, they gave him $15.2 billion. He rejected. What a holy man. Is that why we came here?
Israel airplane is monitoring Nigeria. Israel want to bomb Nigeria. Biafran's indigenous people of Nnamdi-Kanu, you cannot run to Israel embassy in Nigeria and get your cover. Israel want to protect us. Israel have been provoked. They are going to destroy Nigeria. Laya Mohammed, you say, all these things, why you are doing all this rubbish? You even drag most of the people we hold in high esteem into this rubbish. Hey, Abaribe said he's going to fight Nigeria if they don't bring in Nnamdi-Kanu to court. Who told you? Obio Funicha said he's going to be in the court on the 26th. Who told you? Are you deceiving us? Or you are deceiving Fulani? Or you are deceiving Yoruba? Who exactly are you deceiving? In your ignorance, you let them control us. You let them control our realm. And each time we are trying to make you people see, you won't understand. The same way we were trying to point out all this error to Nnamdi-Kanu. Mazimefo practically called him. The issue of religion should not come into what we are doing. Because these are matter greater than you. Must respect everybody for who they are. He talked to Nnamdi-Kanu severally internally. And then he went on social media and made his stand known to people. Today now, we don't know if Nnamdi-Kanu is a born again. We don't know if he's Arabatarian. We don't know if he's a Robotarian. It will be better for him to go and become Afa. Just to deceive the people. Now, while you are putting up all this drama, the Fulanis are still controlling us in the days of ignorance. Ngige made his stance. He said the more powerful is hallucinating for the rubbish they are talking. Where are all of you who say that you are IPOB, you are this one? All of you have hid around and now. It is now your barrister, Barrister Jofor and Barrister Lloyd Jimako. Of course, they are members of IPOB. Only that they didn't take oath. They are not the one encouraging you. Barrister Jofor is telling you, don't worry, Eloha is going to do miracle. Just be faithful and remain strong. Because he's stealing money. Barrister Jofor is stealing money. Go and ask the people holding Bia Foundation account. Who collected more money from that money, that account that brought issue? That account Darlington was shouting about. They have diverted it. The truth is gradually coming out. Go and check Barrister Jofor. Ask him about the money. Okay, it's illegal bill. It is they paid in illegal bill. I'll be legal bill. They are all IPOB members. All of us were. They are not the one encouraging you. Don't worry, be strong. Hello, why we do it? We are moving forward. So where are all the formidable? Where are the genuine men that were on ground? Nnamdi-Kanu have betrayed all of them. They are hiding. They are afraid to talk. Only George Onyimbe. All of you hide very well. The time you people will start coming up to see what has happened, you will meet another game. This is now or never. Yes, we encourage you. Hi, Barrister Jimako, Alamako. Is this how the country is going to be? Is that how this Biafra will be? You see, we had a picture. We have a dream that was Biafra. And soon we discover it is so fragile. You can only whisper it and then it is gone. And now we knew we have to stand our ground and make it truly visible. In your ignorance. We know the truth already. We know the way. Nnamdi-Kanu love this money. He want to die on top of monthly due. But yet he has just rejected 15.2 billion Fulani Janjaweed gave to him. Why you are doing this? In your ignorance. They are controlling us. Our realm. They are in control already. It's unfortunate. While we are busy running up and down with cock and bull stories, dashing out propagandas, slandering one another, blackmailing one another, these people are busy beating us in our own game. Absolutely in control. They control everything. Political realm, they control it. Political realm. There is no governor in Biafra land that can win any election without going to the caliphate. Once they endorse you, you will go to Ugwu Hausa and take your own oath.
And then they tell you, we are under oath to serve Nigeria, not you. So politically, they control us. And these people are battling with power that are greater than them. We could savage them. But the platform for them to come forward and form a synergy with the people is no longer there because he has been destroyed. Destroyed by the same man, Nnamdi Kanu. How many years has he told us? We don't work with politicians. We don't hear politicians. Politicians are evil. They are criminals. They are janjaweed. They are Fulani blood. They are Hausa boyfriend. He calls them all manner of name. But he go behind and collect money from them. You see, what will shock all of you one day is the day any of you will think you are defending your own. That is the day you are killing all of us. We have evidence to everything we tell you. But we're saving the best dance step for the last competition. Tell me one governor that Nnamdi Kanu has not collected money from. And then I will sacrifice myself on the altar of this freedom. All the governors in the Southeast, maybe only Okowa and Wike didn't give him money. South, South, and Southeast. In fact, he has succeeded in bending all the governors in the Southeast, subdue them completely. Kingmaker. And so the moment you don't give him money, he says, hey, he's a saboteur, he's idiot, he's a criminal, they destroy him. And once they give him money, the same person condemning them will begin to preach them. But while you are doing all these things, Fulani controls them. All of you, are you telling me now that Hopus Odema have confidence in Imo people as much as they have in Hausa people? And now maybe you begin to understand why Rogers Okorocha loyalty goes to the north, not his people. You people have pushed Hopus Odema to the same point. His loyalty is to the north, not to the people of Biafra. But they are not cursed. They know the truth. That syndrome of if you can't beat them, you join them, has compelled them to do what they are doing. Make fame in Imo State. That guy in Douglas' house will call the north, and they will round all of you up, and you can only cry. But what is the solution? The same hooliganism? No. So politically, they control us. Politically, they controlled us. When we talk about the first president of Nigeria, call it ceremonial, unofficial, or official, the first president of Nigeria, is it not Nnamdi Azikiwe? And so, if you begin to put this story together, where was Nnamdi Azikiwe when Chukwuma Nzogo did what he did? Where was Nnamdi Azikiwe when Agu Yorosi assumed the leadership of president in Nigeria? Where was Nnamdi Azikiwe? He abandoned his own. He was busy gallivanting the whole Africa. Zeke of Africa. And now if God is not merciful to all of us, they will take Nnewi from all of you. Am I condemning him tonight? No. But this is the time for us to understand the true meaning of our politicians. These are people taken from among the people to represent the people for the overall interest of the people, and we must guide them. How do we guide them? How do we guide them? The only thing we know is organized meeting, how to oppress some people, intimidate some people, then assume supremacy over some people in every front. That is what we can do to ourselves. And so why we play this local game? The janjaweed, they are the one running us. They control our political realm. Without what is happening now, Nnamdi Kanu 150 days, end on Anambra election. It will destabilize everywhere. When Atiku and P2B came out, we know how much they gave to them. From that money, Benjamin Madubugu bought tear rubber.
Those of you who are volunteer in Benjamin House, did you not see Ghana must go? Did you not see Ghana must go? Though most of you have been betrayed. All of you in Imo State who went to vote for Atiku and Peter, did they not pay you 2,000, 3,000, 5,000? Come out and talk. Let me tell you how much they gave to you. Because you have been sealed, delivered, and documented. How can you be sincere? Now you know how they, you now see why they control our political arena. We are here telling cockaboo story. While we are telling cockaboo story, dishing out propaganda, they control our academic realm. Is it not amazing that inside one Nigeria, somebody from Anambra have to score about 300 to get admission? Then they will leave Anambra, they will come to Abia. Somebody from Abia must score 280. And then from Abia, they move to Imo. Somebody from Imo must score 270. And then they enter Delta. Somebody from Delta must score 250. And then they go round that way in south, south, and southeast, Biafra land. And then they cross to the west. And so somebody from the west will score 200 or 180. The greatest insult now is that somebody from Sokoto will have to score 6. They are even begging them. And in fact, he just scored 1. Do they not control the economic realm? But at the end of the day, after graduation, they will be the one who are MD. Directors in every parasitator. They will be in charge of everything. So what is the use of going to school? And only those of you that your father can afford to send you to diaspora to read masters can only come back and have relevance. And those of us whose father cannot send us to go and get PhD in America or anywhere around the world, we graduate and start riding Okada. It's not supposed to be so. And all of you in the bush riding Okada, all of you jobless graduate who is following in on the canoe for almost 10 years now, have you asked yourself a question? Where is the way forward? Respect you don't have, money you don't have, dignity you don't have. Even the Nnamdi Kanu has killed us more than the Fulani Janja. Let's not say anything. Do you know why it is becoming very hard for the unification of the Biafran people? Because most of these things happened in time past, and those who are supposed to speak up kept quiet. Under one umbrella, now, look at how many years we are still suffering, giving room to caliphate to control all our life. My brother, if we don't address this issue, we are only cooking up another poisonous dish for the next generation. And may God not allow that to happen. May Tuanya Kagyo Ulilanya Ndenso. May Tuanya Kagyo Apata Nekungwau. Meto anya kagio unyoma nemema meto anya kagio chimo ekwekwolaka kaiburu oria winawo ekwekwolaka aiburu akpikpere alawawo ekwekwolaka ainjutu awina meto anya kagi chimo. Let God not allow us to leave this stage with this disease. You're covering. Who are you covering for? Who are you covering for? In our ignorance, they control our realm. We just go to school. Let it not be as if your father did not train you. We just go to school so we can be able to speak. Just preparation, you never know the opportunity that will come tomorrow. You no longer go to school, so you become useful. No. You come to look at the educational sector, it's even going backward. And that is because some people want it to be that way. Because they control the realm. Since I was born, aeroplane innovation has gone through more than 70 different upgrades. As a child, the first man to buy fridge in my community, his fridge, when I mean fridge, the cooling system, thermocool, as they call it then, his own have exhaust. Fridge have exhaust like motorcycle. You can imagine if we were using it now. And then with time, they begin to upgrade it. And that is because the world is on a fast lane to development. Those people, the same school curriculum they use is what we are still using today. Our own know the upgrade. Are we going to die on an analog when the world is already on a fast page for software? But you won't understand. Let's proceed. And of course, they control our religious realm. They control our religious realm. Forget about Adeboye. Forget about Kumuyi. Forget about this man of God. All of them, they are answerable to the Emir of Kano. Is it not Emir of Kano? All of them, all this your general overseer, the head of religion in Nigeria is a caliphate. He makes the law that governs the church. Have you wondered why they tell you church will be registered? Churches are registered. It's gradually, churches will begin to remit their tithe and offering. Auditors will be set up. They are just waiting for these champions in the church to expire. They will come for it. If they can condemn beer not to be sold in their land, and yet they collect the proceeds from that beer and use it to develop the north. Don't you see they control your realm already? So religiously they control you. They control your Jesus Christ. They control you religiously inside this Nigeria. People who see you as infidel, they never had respect for your Jesus nor your Virgin Mary. But they are the one who decide how you're going to worship them. And the day you stand up and you speak against their Muhammad, even somebody from America speak against Muhammad, they kill you here in Nigeria because you are a Christian. And still, you don't understand they control our realm. Have we been able to stop them in all this area? Have we actually made any deliberate effort to stop all these things? And how do we make the effort? By fighting, by killing our people, by terrorizing everybody, by blackmailing ourselves. But I think if you know there is a problem, that problem eventually is half solved. So let's begin to point out these things to you so you know we have an issue. You talk about economical realm. They control it. They control our economical realm. I thank God for determination of our people to continually be in business. At least making effort to make ends meet. But imagine if we were functioning on a fair ground. They are trying to sponsor a bill that now gives Dangote the sole right to deal with petroleum product in Nigeria. He has monopoly over Maggi. He's in charge of tomato. Only him have the cement. Only him import trailer. Only him is in charge of cow. Everything is Dangote. And yet you cannot see that economically that the realm is being controlled by these people. Who has moved any bill to discuss about the issue of Ibeto? He said, the brother, he did something, he did wrong. What did he do the Fulani and the Yoruba did not do? Before your very present, all of you were there. They destroyed Banugo. Where is All State Trust Bank? Yaradua, late Yaradua and his family took over that bank. Allah Messiah have to die for it. And then he become full any bank, bank PHB at the Keystone Bank. And then at the end of the day, what happened? Those ones don't steal money. Yet you can't see they control that realm economically. Where is Oceanic Bank? If Nigeria is not benefiting from Aero Contractor, it would have been shut down. Where is Hebrew Fishing? Where are all these industrial giants or magnets? Where are all of them? If they create a fair economic playing ground for every Nigerian, supposedly, people like Dangote will not even own a single shop. But we are comfortable with it. These are the things we should begin to think of how to change. We're almost there. Until the power of dollar overwhelm on Nandekano. Ara Bandiara. They talk about security. They control our realm. Our land is under military occupation. This is no longer news. If we want to consider tonight, even the diplomatic realm, who speaks for us? Who speaks for us? They control that realm also. These are areas of interest that concerns us as a people, being controlled by others. We talk about cultural realm. They control it. Try and tune to NTA International. Is it Nigerian Television Authority or National Television Authority, if it's still working anyway? Tune to it and tell me that Nigeria is not an Islamic country. They destroy our image, project their image as if we are all Alamajiri. When they show 20 people in your TV, Nigerian National, what is NTA? And Nigerian Television Authority. Just on it, you think we are Saudi Arabia. You will think we are Saudi Arabia. Because everywhere have been Allahized. Allah. It's Allah that owns it. So where are the Christians? And somebody say, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Why will it matter? When you don't see they control those realms. Many countries in the world today have black indigenous. But they hide them. They demean them. India have black people. Watch Nollywood, Bollywood, Indian Wudu. All of them, you hardly see a black man. And you think it's okay like that. The blacks don't have sense. And that is what you will say. Now, those of you in Nigeria, go back to your Go TV. Supposedly from a Christian country, South Africa. They have a Yoruba platform. Almost three platform given to Yoruba people. Almost three platform given to Hausa people. And then they come to Biafran people, Igbo people, unquote. They gave us, they host us on African Magic. Watch that channel very well. It's not specific for Igbo. You are being host, managed, entertained on African Magic. But it doesn't mean after all, Anna Swibo na Go TV, all them mad that way. Understand all these things. If we cannot control this realm, it is practically impossible for us to begin to say we want to free ourselves from Nigeria. You are hallucinating. First thing first. But we can't tell them everything. So culturally, they control the realm. When you want Igbo man want to make presentation in national television, he will be compared to dress like Hausa or Fulani. We talk about the policy realm. They control it. those areas of interest, I can go on and begin to explain, we will leave here today. But every area of overall interest to our people, this realm is being controlled by another people. People who don't have our interest at heart. These are supposed to be areas of our dominance. But it's temporarily being controlled by others. We must remain focused and make sure that they do not have absolute dominion over this realm, or else we are gone as a people. Yes, they have control over all this realm. But this is the time for us to re-strategize. We cannot afford to allow them to have dominion over us in these areas. We cannot allow them to have complete dominion. If we do, we are gone as a people. And so every pro-Biafran group must understand. Begin to do what you are doing. We may not all completely agree. In our ideology, we may not all be on the same page. In our modus operandi, it doesn't matter. But the point is that we are very much interested in constitutional amendment, if it will be possible. We are very much interested in devolution of power, if it is possible. We are very much interested in restructure, if that will ever be. Anything that will change our current position, statues in Nigeria, we will fight for all of them. But the ultimate aim is let Nigeria return to be the way it was before the supposedly amalgamation. Let the West go to the West. Let the North go to the North. Let the East go to the East. And then in the end, let everybody focus on their platform, on their jurisdiction. And of course, at this line moment, our lines are open and you are free to call in. Don't let anybody deceive you by propagandas and lies. Let us reevaluate our position on how we have lost it all. And then that is the only way we can get it back. By retracing our footstep. This is the time to restrict our footstep. Don't think this is 2015 or 2017. 2015 is the arresting and the canon. Eloha is going to come and do miracle. Eloha has finished his miracle. Now the canon need to repent and apologize. Barrister Jofor and Barrister Lawyer Ajimako. Now their own misery starts. Where are all the coordinators? John Paul Maduabuchi is a saboteur. But you people never know how we labored to bring the West together. Kenneth Ogan is a saboteur. But you people don't know the sacrifice that guy made, almost shut down his business to keep the North together. Where are all the other saboteurs? Only Muguna and the Kano can use, harass them, collect all the money. Yet is the one rejecting 15.2 billion. You people can carry propaganda as you like. That will not sell market anymore. It won't sell market. If you love Igbo, if you love Ijo, if you love Ogoni, if you love Urobo, if you love Ishekiri, if you love Igala, if you love Idoma, if you love Akwa Ibom, if you love Oboburua, Tinapa, Ugebo, if you love all of them, Biafran, Yanogwa, you love your people. This is the time we must stand for the absolute truth and nothing but the truth. Our lines are open at this moment. First of all, this is developing human capacity. We are trying to develop human capacity, empowering the next generation to be able to stand to the task ahead of us. And of course, now the Kano zombies are busy threatening you. Don't listen to George Onyebe. Don't follow all these people. They are the saboteur. We will kill all the governor. We will kill all the this one. We will kill. But let me remind you. Nobody has monopoly over this. When issue of militants started, they said they were kidnapping the expatriates, Oyibo. And they made huge amount of money under ransom. And then Oyibo ran away and start sending us. So no Oyibo to kidnap. Eventually, they start kidnapping our people. No more our expatriate to kidnap. They start kidnapping king. And then maybe even common man. Kidnapping went on rampage. And so when you are saying, we will kill our governor, Very soon there will be no governor to kill again. And then you will put the blame on those in diaspora. Let us kill all our people in diaspora. And very soon you won't see them to kill. And then you will not come back home. It's our Igwe. Let us kill them. And very soon, no Igwe to kill. And then you will say it is the market women. That is what you will do till you will kill yourself. So when the can is saying, and then come man, we will teach you lesson. We are doing this. But then he was destroying his own people because he was not principled. He was not guided. He doesn't listen to advice. And when he finished making his mess, some people like, oh, he's a hero. He's a rich and dirty hero. Can anybody truly analyze what he has done here? Only in your ignorance will you come out and say he did this, because you people don't even know the real mind behind this machine. This machine that he knocked the engine. And they are trying to do propaganda. Are we fighting for a propaganda nation? And of course, the line is open. You are free to call. Call and insult me. Call and say what you want to say. But understand, I hold this mic. If I say stop, you stop. If I say talk, you talk. If you think otherwise, I cut you off. Or better still, don't even cut. It makes my job easier for me. You want to be developed in terms of human capacity, reach out to Biafra Nation Alliance. You want to be empowered to be able to face this war, this battle, reach out to Biafra Nation. Forget about those people threatening you. Obuagboko Hure here. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. 070-815-45642. And then our direct line is 081-221-52971. 081-221-52971 is our direct line. And then once again, our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. You are free to call in and make your positive contribution, but the issue of Biafra cannot be turned down. We will not leave any stone unturned. The people of Biafra, the entrapped ethnic nationality in this evil enclave called Nigeria, must begin to work very, very hard. Must begin to work very, very hard to ensure that Biafra is completely liberated and the next generation may have the privilege to be able to do what they're supposed to do. Yes, of course, at this moment I'm joined by one of us. Can you hear me? Caller on WhatsApp. Can you hear me?
I can hear you clearly. Good evening, Diapa.
Good evening from here, my brother. Go ahead, please.
Okay, sir. What I want to tell some people, Saga, I want to make our people just reason. Take their common sense and digest what is going on. And what happened 2015 repeat itself again. After Brother Clifford Iriadem donated a very huge amount of money, give a criminal canoe to go for somewhere for important something. Then what they had is they arrested Nnamdi Kanu in Nigeria, Lagos. Now, that money that Nnamdi Kanu took out, when he come out from prison, he did not give account of those money. It is only last
they know what they are doing now. Barrister Lawyer Jimako has gone to his Twitter handle. He said update today, I met with Tony Ndu at the DSS. We spent nearly 4 hours, jobless people. My interaction with him was fulfilling. He's cherry and took forward and look forward to overcoming this predicament sooner than later. Again, he stressed unity, tolerance,
on all sides. He has all in his thought. Now the canoe is supposedly inside the DSS is stressing unity. And he came on Radio Biafra and told you that Anioma is nonsense. What if on this mic I tell you Igbo is nonsense? Is that the unity?
No.
But now he's inside the prison he put himself. Let him be bargaining, we are waiting. But to some people it doesn't make sense. How many make were royal? How many merok were jahing? Now they cannot come on Radio Biafra and say Anioma is nonsense. And some people entertain it and say Anioma nonsense. Who give him the right? Who gave him that right? But now he's Alaa Ejimakor is telling you he's stressing unity. Why did they not advise him? They were just interested in our money.
Hold on,
I'm coming. And then he said tolerance. How many people did he tolerate? Tolerance of Iruanya? Tolerance of Ike Nawan Onini? Tolerance of Omiomio? Did he tolerate Ima Mezu? When he died, they start laughing at him. All these are deceivers. He can't walk.
He used Ima Mezu to do broadcast.
He start telling us tolerance. Let him collect his amnesty and come out. Let's reposition the whole journey. The rubbish. This is a lawyer, Ejimakor and Barristo Talos should be ashamed of themselves. These are registered IPOB members. All of us who fought IPOB, all of us, we will talk about it one day. Illegal lawyers and criminals. Somebody cut this out and send it to them. That's why when I look at idiot like a Solomon Ebu threatening me with British court, I pity for him. The people inside suppose Zoo are running. Is it you that is in London? That may not even come home again.
No, let him come back. Make it come back. Come
where are the now coordinators now? Where are the coordinators now? Where are the Biafra land coordinators now? The ones that have brain, Nandekano has demonized them. Now all these ones are trying to see how they will scoop all the money that is left. Scoop all of them. That is why people like Darlington and Ife and the rest of them are reacting. Nothing more, nothing less.
Darlington is a criminal.
I know he's a criminal, very hardened one. He's responsible for more than 90% of the atrocity in Enugu when Nnamdi Kanu was arrested in 2015. I have all their record. Onye wepu ha ise enye Jizo Pabeli Eka. But for sake of trust issue, we ignore them and be looking at them. The role of Barristo Jofor and Alaa Ejimakor are playing, it is detrimental to everything we believe in. The earlier they know and withdraw their step and stop deceiving people, the better for all of us. The other one, he spent 3 hours. Nandekano Nanyo Anyo. He gave different description. Ujofor give another one. Now he's another one. He spent 4 hours. Nandekano say, hey, unite. Who is he uniting? You can't unite with your governors. You can't unite with Obi of Onitsha. You can't unite with Nayangodu. You refuse to unite with Rafael Wazurike. He didn't say that. Obionicha didn't say that. They are just propaganda.
I know that Obionicha did not
say that.
Now they are fake news now where they carry
rubbish
up and down.
Set of people. Go ahead, please, my brother.
So, my brother, let me continue where I stop. What did Nandekalu do 2015? That after he collected the money to go and do something, they make an agreement. Now, all the money that Nandekalu used enter prison, he did not come out with anyone. Now, he still play the same game again. All the whole money where they contribute for ESM, then Nandekalu go to prison. And this his girlfriend with a mother and some people, they go play smart, quickly go and withdraw all the money. Then Nandekalu there for sale. Now call Darlington, his fellow criminal. Tell him. Then Darlington now come out. Hey, we get the intelligent officer, our intelligent Mugusu, where they everywhere. Our intelligent Mugusu, where they everywhere, where they go everywhere. Then don't give us all the list. All the list will be say why they go withdraw money. This money, Nandekalu, Nandoyoshi, Signa, Nandekalu for that money. They go with Ram. But you know, go talk who given the information because he is not among, but he will tell them that they are easy. Nan de Kalo, na criminal Kalo tell them all those things because Nan de more powerful, that is Nan de Kalo criminal brother. Nan de Kalo put to him to be monitoring. Happen, but I am not there. But what I'm telling you is pure truth. And I come on air. This one, they be criminal. Those people, this is useless talent in them. They are called criminal. They are not criminals. They try to save this money, but this criminal wants where they leave that money for Nandekal account so that they go withdraw that money. Claim that the DSS collected that money so that he will collect his own. The more powerful will collect, and then the criminal will now take the rest. This is what is going on. And for you to know that these people are sincere for what they are doing, immediately come on air to talk that rubbish with them. Those people now send that money back for him to know that they don't want to eat that money. But he still come on air to condemn them that they steal that money. That Darlington is a very wicked soul. He claimed that he is fighting for Biafra. But I go tell him this night, let this broadcast reach him. I go tell him this night that what happened to Kano, the worst one will happen to him. The worst one will happen to Darlington. Nnamdi Kanu, he come on air to talk on a beach, then he never tell people where they arresting Nnamdi Kanu. If he know that he is pure of what he is doing, both Nnamdi Kanu lawyer and everybody, let them tell us the place they arrest Nnamdi Kanu. Go to jail and speak. If you want to know where they arrest Nnamdi Kanu, go to jail and speak, and you will see the man from London. It is a video broadcast. The man said it clear where they arrested Nnamdi Kanu and how Nnamdi Kanu take worker. He said that from March this year, the British government declared IPOB terrorist, which everybody know. See, there was a time they declared IPOB terrorist. That was time Nnamdi Kanu run away from British. And he, Nnamdi Kanu, knew that he will not, Nnamdi Kanu knew that he will not take air, because if he went to air, they will arrest him. So he go through road, enter Ethiopia. So from there, he is hiding from African country to African country. So this broadcast he is doing all these days, he was hiding from African country to African country. But he is a fool. He know that he is hiding. Still, that prick when he get, no the let and rest. He went to Kenya through land to go and fuck a woman. That was where they catch him for hotel. Then I probably fools, they don't they ask themselves, because now they cannot give command. That woman, they call him for US, when he take good secretary, that he should tweet him on his name. That lady should tweet him on his name. Now, that woman don't know their foolishness, we call themselves intelligent people. Their foolishness not tell them, say they don't arrest Nnamdi Kanu, because Nnamdi Kanu did not tell anybody where he go to. Then they continue their tweets with his Twitter. They tweet with his Twitter even till May 30th. They don't know say they catch Nnamdi Kanu, because Nnamdi Kanu is a criminal. He don't tell anybody where they go. And the effort is correct for what he's saying. Nnamdi Kanu tweeted from 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 23, 30th, where they can say Nnamdi Kanu for court. Who do that tweet the Twitter? Now that girl, when they call a secretary, when you know they tell truth, But soon, the truth will come out, because with this talenting talk that girl is a criminal, that girl will speak up. If that girl did not speak up, he would die silently. That girl need to speak up. If she did not speak up, she would die silently. So this is the evil they are committing. The most evil person in IPOB is Darlington. The most evil and the dangerous person is Darlington. So this Darlington knew that Nnamdi Kanu was arrested, and they want to cover Nnamdi Kanu. He want to cover Nnamdi Kanu. He start calling everybody evil. And this Darlington never knew that Nnamdi Kanu will still disappoint him, because for him to call Nnamdi Kanu uncle, saboteur, Nnamdi Kanu never hear that one. For Darlington to come on air, the killer Nnamdi saboteur, Darlington go still hear him now. Only say the truth, according to wait, be this a girl one barrister where talk a word. He say Nnamdi Kanu case, he did not cheer that Nnamdi Kanu will come out in 20 years time, because Nnamdi Kanu committed everything by himself. He used his mouth to commit himself. And again, if you go to jail and speak, go listen to that man. The man talk that even Nigeria releasing Nnamdi Kanu to British will jail him straight, because they have received many of Nnamdi Kanu terrorizing a country, and it is against international law for you to be on air and they are anything terrorizing a sovereign nation. So Nnamdi Kanu was on air terrorizing sovereign nation of Nigeria, claiming that he will go and they bring the head of Nigerian president on air, claiming that he have equipped 2 million people made to kill all the Nigerian soldiers anywhere they see them, claiming that he is the one responsible that any police station burn, which they are seeing that the Nigeria have police stations. We are not talking of police stations. We are talking about police stations where they say them burn down. And then Nnamdi Kanu still come on air, claim he is the one and is his voice. So Nnamdi Kanu is in trouble before the international community. So this is Nigeria now we Olam. And all these his zombies where they follow criminal Kanu never knew that Nnamdi Kanu committed against international communities. Now the question is, Osama bin Laden, did he go to any place to bomb? The answer is no. But Osama bin Laden on air, any place they bomb America, he will claim it that he is the one send the boys. Whether him or not him, is it not the reason they kill him? So what is the difference between Osama bin Laden and then Nnamdi Kanu when he will be on air claiming every atrocities in Nigeria? They start answers. They are not killing people. Then Nnamdi Kanu down command to start killing people, burning houses, go kill Tinubu, go kill Ambod. If you see Ambod, their daughter kill her. Even they kidnap they go staff of office of Oba Akiolu of Lagos. Nnamdi Kanu claims saying him send people where do am, saying those people they be formidable people. He claim it. Then some people come, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Onyendu, hey, Ezigbo Onyozi, God go bless him. international people go come back. Which international people they come back? No single international man that will be put in hand for Nandi Kalu. And for their information, this money that Darlington is fighting for is making share with Ifeanyi Ojiofor and Ejimakor. This money, maybe this money will be said Darlington they fight for. This money will be safe. Darlington they fight for. Now to share them with Ejimakor and the Ejiofor. Now making share them because the truth is that if I use Ejiofor and the Ejimakor, more clearly that Nnamdi Kanu is not coming out even this year and the next year, they know. So if you take it up, where they give IPOB fools. If I Ejiofor is not telling truth, Ejimakor is not telling truth, Nnamdi Kanu is not telling truth, Darlington is not telling truth, they are liars. All of them are liars. So, brother, I don't know anybody where they doubt what I talk today. Where they go to jail and speak, they will see that man talking, telling them how Nnamdi Kanu take you wrong for in London.
Thank you very much.
For March.
Thank you very much.
The man even talked. The man even tells everybody about Nnamdi Kanu, what Nnamdi Kanu is doing in London before he struggled. The man talk where Nnamdi Kanu lives, everything. Nnamdi Kanu is nobody. Even Mefo. He's hiding things from Nnamdi Kanu. That Mefo come out to tell people Nnamdi Kanu is nobody. He don't have any work. Let him come, said it.
Thank you very much.
If Nnamdi Kanu get work, let people go to his working place. Show us. Nnamdi Kanu is nobody. He don't have any handwork. If Biafra fraudulent, he do before he get work, before he begin the job. Thank you, brother. Let me be listening to others.
Yes, we must continue. You, our brother, has spoken at length, and that is how it is. That is just the truth. We cannot allow the same people who control our realm ignorantly to dominate that realm. What are the things empowering them? What are the things that are keeping them? All of us, they're playing us like game. And at the end of the day, what do we do? What have we done? Caller on the line. Caller on the line. Good
Hello?
Evening from here. Your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, I come from Lagos.
Go ahead, please.
Is it George Onibe?
Yes, you are on to George Onibe, and this is Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station. It's a live program. Go ahead, please.
Yeah. Good evening, everybody. I want to speak about what is going on in Nigeria about Nnamdi Kanu and the federal government of Nigeria.
Go ahead, please.
Hello?
Go ahead, please. The world is listening.
Yeah. I come from Lagos. Yeah. We have George Onibe. I thank. Yeah. May God bless you for good work you are doing for You see, you have talked so much about Nnamdi Kanu. We know Nnamdi Kanu many years ago. You see, Nnamdi Kanu today is manipulating Igbo youths. But they don't want to listen. They call him, they call him savior of Igbos. But Nnamdi Kanu cannot save himself. He can't save himself. This country, whether George, whether Nnamdi Kanu have gone or not have gone, something happened in Abuja in 2010, October, when they blow that bomb in Abuja, where the worker said that he's won. They changed him in South Africa. Up to today. So we, Nigerians, we know Igbos are suffering, or Biafrans are suffering in Nigeria. But when we do this, no violence, I believe because God will help Biafrans to locate their promised land. No hand will catch, no hand will hold our person. How many, 3 years after 1967 to 1970, 3 million people died. Today, instead of Nigeria killing Biafras, our brothers are killing us today. Many people are dying in England, dying in Biafra land. Nnamdi Kanu is living large in America. Kenya. Even Kenya is the one who catches Nnamdi Kanu. What is the problem? Nnamdi Kanu is not in Kenya, it's in Ethiopia. From Tanzania to Ethiopia. When Nnamdi Kanu left Canada, we know about this story. I tell you the whole world now. Nnamdi Kanu, after I have ally with him, Tanzania, he visits them. From there, he go to Gabon, to Ethiopia. Today, everybody, Kenya. What is Kenya? Chief Raff was here, and Fatou government, which people are heading, want unity, let everybody come together. The only IPOP is the one who do not believe unity of this country, unity of Biafra. Don't talk about the Nnamdi Kanu so much in this idea. Tell us about the other things. Allow the guy to go. The federal government needs Nnamdi Kanu. We know that Nnamdi Kanu is working with the federal government. Everybody dying. Agwalami, this one is. When it was Ike, they killed Nnamdi Kanu. Everybody, I guess, last was Ike. But today, instead of killing somebody and naked, which one is best? The best. Even naked is people. Look at 400 and something people have died in nowhere. Go to Montreal, and I think Montreal and everything, everyone is filled up. Because they want to have the effort.
Quite unfortunate, I lost that caller. And of course, if you can still call back, that will be appreciated. Our brother was making his point. He simply said, well, let's just leave Nnamdi Kanu and move ahead. And that is exactly what we are going to do. Just that the matter has not ended. He is still playing game. He is renegotiating with Nigeria. Nnamdi Kanu asked some youth to stay in his house. But he was not in his house. If I have spent another 10 minutes, maybe I would have been shot dead in Nnamdi Kanu's house. But he was not in the house. He knew what was going to happen. He removed his parents and he left. All his family members, none of them were there. Some of these zombie who still cannot see gave their life that day. For nothing.
He never mentioned their name. He never talked about that. He said, oh, it's my dog, Jack. They killed my dog, Jack. You think he's a human being? And they evacuated him. After evacuated him, he appeared in Israel. Don't you know people facilitate all those things? Don't you know how to take people who are in the government to facilitate all those things? Let him finish that negotiation. Now they cannot finish your negotiation. Yeah, it is here when they arrest, I can say, wait, leave our brother. Oh, they have our brother selling us, or be which of them? This one now. Dear friends, we know the truth. It's a promise. Call on the line. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
You call back. Go ahead, please.
It's a business. So, I want to continue with my...
Yes, go ahead. The world is listening.
Yeah, you see, we have... George Onyedo to market in America so much. Let's see live about this in America. After all, the federal government have already been standing. Nation, the African nation have already been standing. We don't need this year. Let us, because one person can never be bigger than the Afla. Today we complain. Yeah. I go back. We talk about Fulani dominated everywhere. Secretary of the tell me the South people today who is in Biafra position. Nani kind of brother. Biafra spokesman in Nigeria. Memekano in Germany. Foreign affairs spokesman. Treasurer. Nani kind of cousin. Everything. Tell me, South, during the Juku time, election is a deputy, so Juku vice president in the Afra government. She everything, which is Juku Marija, who condemn, it's not a woman, it's a lady of the Afra. Juku she everything for people to everybody, to go to Nadekano from one state, other state, take everything. China won is from other state. Everything. My brother, this we can't serve Nanikan enough. We followed him, but today we know that the Nanikan is doing pure 419 for Biafrans. But they don't want to listen. Nanikan dissolve Biafra. Dissolve IPOP in London when British government served in paper with each other before. Which of us will honor that paper, but the nine can do not come. He left to Canada. From Canada to US. He tell all the whole evil women to donate money. They want to buy drone. All today do not buy that drone. Now those women are asking him to cancel for that drone because Han Nani can enter prison again. When people are asking him, money to buy during 2015, man can come to Nigeria instead of Ukraine, Nigeria. The women of US are asking man can to count for money for drone, man can today in prison in Nigeria. My brother, you have tried, judge your neighbor. Don't talk about man can in this radio. Give us the message you are giving us. When I hear you, my mind calm down. You cannot die for one person. Look at today. There's one program I watch about his in-law, Master Prophet. If you know the kind of not pregnancy, 1,000 women, Biafra cannot come. Look at okay, man is talking. The same Master Prophet tells the whole world that he's the one who speaks Trump becomes. He come out the second time of Trump. Trump will enter to the Trump firm. A man is seeing tomorrow. he do not see nine can go in prison. But it's a man who is the head of. Because of this man, the key was Prophet Okoro for him to take over. Everybody become his own family. Didn't Prophet Okoro, nine can receive from him. They caught the man. In-law have taken over today. Okay, let me see in this. Well, may God bless you. I thank God you are doing well. When they thought that you people would go down, God said no. Tell the whole Biafran the truth. Truth is better than prayer. What I know, whatever goes up will come down. No matter how lizard go up, illegally will come down. And then I can have a with Brigade. They have problems. Number four in the world. The wife of Brigade have deported himself because the second son is against the court of Nnamdi Kanu and the Brigade. They have already scattered. If Nnamdi Kanu come out in this place, you know the court love him. Thank you, Mr. George Oliva. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
May God bless you.
Thank you. And of course, those are sincere men. Those are reasonable people. Those are spiritual, sensible people. One of them just called now. The issue of Biafra is a matter of national discourse. We must tell ourselves the whole truth and nothing but the truth. We must look out for the interest of everyone. And we can never agree or accept to become the instrument of our undoing. And if we must say the truth, and then we have to do this sincerely. We have to do this holistically. How long are we going to betray our people? How long? And the pretense that we are fine. For Biafra or what? Under our watch, nobody will be allowed to sell the next generation of Biafra. That will not happen. Can you hear me call on WhatsApp?
Yeah.
Good evening from here. And of course, that is a epileptic network.
Maybe you're stressed every day.
Go ahead.
So I thank you very much for this strength, for this energy. So I want to thank the last caller, you know, for his own word. Seen that our people, most of our people, they never understand many lies and many dubious words about Nnamdi Kanu. And the kind of Biafra we are fighting for is a democracy Biafra where people are going to speak their own opinions. And anything, any government or any leader that don't accept criticism, so that leader do not want to be a leader, because one of the characteristics of leading that a leader must expect is criticism, and there is a criticism that needs change. So I think at this point in time, our people will need. Friend is telling me that I should go, that we have nothing to offer, we have nothing to achieve. I achieve so much, a lot, because I can see a place I can listen to hear the progress and have. Because I never move with anybody with sentiment. So, I know somebody telling me lies. So, all this wise, I lost a place where I can talk, where I can listen about Biafran and movement. I've not seen it. So, for Human Rights Radio, radio arrived. So, and when this radio arrived, it gives me another courage again. It gave me a place where I can find people that reason, where I can find people that think the way I think. So, and I left and I see that you people, Mazi Baby, Mazi Ushemofo, you know, they're just talking similarity of what I'm saying every time I'm on the Biafra. If there is no this, if this video never exists, really, Biafra could have lost a person, like somebody that is following Biafra, which is me. So, but what kind of this video was fun? And time brought Uchemofo and Nnamdi Kanu to the point where they are. And which I know very much, there is no evil man which you can work together with for a long lifetime, and you are trying to command that evil man every day. I know that one day, that evil man must rebel. He doesn't rebel because he wants to rebel, because he is supposed to go, or things is not clear to him, or you are trying to take him to become nobody. I think Uchemofo decided that he had to leave this place. So, and living there, you come to give some people hope again. And then I can hear that some many people are even speaking, not only Uchemofo again, but many people are still speaking the way I am speaking. And these people that have no means before to find their voice, to hear their voice, or to hear where they speak, or to know that the people that think the way I think. Because before I was thinking, sometimes I used to think, am I not thinking awkward? But I said, no, it is not awkward. Because I'm saying it, this is why I always stand alone. So I should not be afraid of standing alone while I'm talking the reality. So, and the day is coming, people that they can speak the way I speak, I'll meet them. And really, I meet them by you people. The truth matter about this issue is that Nnamdi Kanu has been deceived our people a lot. No, they have been deceived them a lot. And this is not, I cannot blame them too much. Because these people, they are the people who know that in their life they cannot do anything. They believe on the concept that they cannot do anything for the restoration of the Afra. But the only thing they can do, they can contribute money. And when they contribute money, they feel that this money, because they have many money, they can do something. But while sometimes it's not everything that your money can serve you, there's something that people who knows you that can help you to solve while you don't really have money. So, and what I'm seeing here now is our people are being brainwashed. The kind of work you are doing, especially in this platform, I see it like, to restore our people's mind, to lighten our people more, to bring them back to their normal senses. So, I think it's not a bad idea he gave by stop talking about non-camp. It's true. A time is coming when we know that it's not time to speak about him anymore. But our people must understand this truth. We must understand this truth. And why they must understand it is because we are pursuing a stain and a particular nation that we know that this nation is just only our hope. That without this nation, we are lost. So if we know any price that we can pay, we have to pay it to get this nation. So I'm sorry for now, for what has been going on in the struggle of Biafra, many years, divisions, and all the rest of it. And I was believing, even before now, that if Nnamdi Kanu never able to give us this Biafra, many people will lose their hope in Biafra. Many people, when you tell them about Biafra, they will tell you, no, I have one guy saying it, that he doesn't care about Biafra anymore, that he just care about Nigeria awards. But me, I don't care about Nigeria because I know there is nothing Nigeria can do for me. Unless those people that are there, everybody die finish, and they remain only our own son that is coming up, they are the people that can be able to do something. But as long as if people are still living there, these the same people are still living there, Nigeria cannot perform anything. And meanwhile, Nigeria has many issues. How many issues they have, I think is very, very difficult to solve. But the one I feel that can be okay for me is to go back to who I was. Because I believe that my four grandfather, they were a people. So let us try whom we were. So that brother, I thank you very much for your own observation. It's a very big one. Trust me, it's a very big one. It's going to help us a lot. But at this time, my own suggestion that people must know this truth, the truth must be told.
Thank you very much.
Because when Nnamdi Kanu was criticizing Wazirike every day, and the people around me, my friends, they come, they criticize, we will talk about the Afro, when I'm telling them what Nnamdi Kanu is missing, they're telling me, Wazirike, do that. I told them, but this man, I see you carrying the Afro flag and making some hosting some things about the Afra, all this. Cannot camouflage the problem. When the government told you to stop this and they pay you for it, you must stop it. You must stop it. So, and they told me, no, the canoe, they have given him even everything. How could somebody tell you that they gave him 5 states to take with the Afra and him? So, there are many lies. We need to bring all these lies and ask these IPOP people to go home and analyze these lies. Sometimes I need to tell my friends, IPOP, well, I say, is this thing you're going to tell to your son, or this is how you want your son to live, your future son, you want to a better place for your son. You're telling your children, and as you know that this Biafra movement is not going nowhere, you like your children to grow up and still started working the way you're working, and they see that this Biafra is not moving forward, and they're telling you that they're moving forward. Like you, I always say, people in the sea without no compass, they can be in a valley for many years, and they are firing, they are burning their fuel, they are doing anything, they think they are going far. They are not going nowhere, they are still in the same place. So, and he has brought all the cameras around him. The Nigerian government has said a lot of interviews for him. And when he gave all these interviews, no one of them have the brain to call him and said, look, you should avoid some interviews. You should avoid some meetings. Now, you want to come and wear suit and tell you that he is the Elohim. Bro, really, I am sorry that Nigerian government is the one judging Nnamdi Kanu. I'm sorry for that, but it could have been more better for me that we, the Biafran, use our own eyes, our own hand to tell him that. from year to year. And all these things, there's no place you can go and show people that this is what you have made for a year. This is what you have made for this money you are contributing. Nothing like that. You call people in Germany, you set a board, you tell them this is Project China, this is this, when it pays to this, it comes to this one, it comes to this one, it comes to this one. After all these things, what have you been able to? I asked them a question. Have you seen anybody that we, the IPOP, we are sending in a book? Money is not there. Okay, we are contributing educational fee. This educational fee, is that any even any school, even two class they build? Okay, defense fund, this defense fund, money to buy ammunition, if when I think from 2014 to 15 in what this money we have been collecting. And in this money, we don't have a place they tell you that this is the deal which are done with this money. No one tells you that kind of thing. And every time I'm hearing we are going by the grace of God, God will give us Biafra. The same way the phone Aremban is saying lie, that you are going to be with them. He comes and use God because you know our people, when they take God, they believe you. Like many people, some people carry Bible to go and play them gamble, to go and play them while they deceive them with Bible. So all I'm saying that I love Biafra. I love Biafra, but I will not be deceived by somebody for Biafra. I will not be the one. If I want, and I'm supporting what Nnamdi Kanu is doing, sending people to go and do this ESN, how will I pay my ticket? This is, I'm telling every Biafra in this Europe to hear this one this night now. Because nobody from Europe go and do that in ESA. If I am in support, the way I have this love and I see that this thing is clear, I told you I will be the first person to go. Something that you know that you cannot embark on, that you cannot defend it. You know, they will soon stop you. In Nigerian government, they will stop you. Because they have not that kind of strategy that will make you to move more forward, to fight, to resist Nigeria for up to 8 months. You can never resist Nigeria as long as you are not the kind of, for what you are seeing, you are doing, you are ranting, you are doing on television, they call it the same thing for you, like water, they go. So, and this is the time you have to get, this is the time where you get to make sure that your business security have to be solid one. That's the solid one. You don't be a solid security, you don't be the solid something, say you're going to fight Nigeria. Are you going to fight Nigeria like the way we lost the previous war? And we went to war with 150 guns. Thank God that all Igbos, we are united, all the Afrans, not Igbos, all the Afrans, we are united to fight this war. And they fought this war. Nigeria could not believe it. The white men, they could not believe it that the Afra can stand Nigeria, even for 6 months. So my own saying this night is the rest of IPOP, which have never ask yourself a question. I want you to begin to ask yourself a question. Go back and replay Nnamdi Kanu, how they call it, peace. His interviews, go back and replace his interviews. Then go and play the broadcast the way they make from when he start to this time. When you take some words, go and elaborate those words. Just, I don't want you to take many words. Just take some few words to, and go and elaborate it on your own. Try to find out as a human being, because everybody has this capability, this strength, this energy to find out, you know, to give yourself the answer, the ready answer, unless you don't want it. So, if George Yonyi Benam is still talking about Nnamdi Kanu today, really, I'm calling it like having an indirect seminar to our people. Because our people, they need to tell the truth and to rehabilitate their mind. So, George Yonyibe, I thank you once more. Let me know to take time more again. Let me give chance to other people to make their own contribution. So, keep doing your good job. I am calling all the lovers of Biafra. I'm not talking to those that love Mazi Onyibe so much. Although they love Chimofu so much, I'm talking about the really people that love this Biafra. Go and think about this Biafra and come back and ask us questions we will ask of this struggle. Because we believe that together we can achieve it all. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Thank you, my brother. We must continue. And the truth cannot be overemphasized. The brother who said we should leave Nnamdi Kanu and let's be doing what we are supposed to do. He was just saying it in a figurative terms, which not everybody understand. But of course, Nnamdi Kanu is still lying. His lawyers are still lying. There are some recruits, they are still lying. Yahoo Yahoo freedom fighters, they are still lying. His brothers and relatives who are in charge of every administration in IPUB, all of them are still lying. And then why should I stop talking about their lies? Some of the zombies are still on my platform, they are still yapping. And anytime anybody raises up attitude that comes from Nnamdi Kanu, my brother will respond. Moreover, it's just barely 6 months I start talking about him. I have about 9 years and 5 months to go. Except in repent. One way or the other, you will hear our voice. But understand, we are not fighting to win. We are fighting for all of us to win. Even now, the Kanu is allowed to roam the street of Biafra the way he is going about. He's going to damage the very fabric existence of our people. The very fabric foundation, he will damage it. We have heard enough stories. We have seen people trying to cover lies. We all pretend for the sake of peace, let's just ignore it. But then we soon discover that this is not what you ignore. These are issues that must be addressed holistically. And that is exactly what we are doing. Sometimes it may irritate you. Sometimes you may feel bad about it. But the truth is that in the end, you will thank God we stood our ground. Not for any selfish benefit, but for the overall interest of the Biafran people in order to preserve, to safeguard the next generation. And of course, at this moment, we are inching closer to the end of this program. I will sincerely appreciate those of you who called in to make your positive contribution. And then, as well, apologize to those of you. I may not be able to take their call this evening again. Tomorrow is another day. And we continue from where we stop. Have you ever wondered how can these caliphate control our land? How can they be beating us in our own game? Time and again, over and over again. What makes these things possible? And that is because somebody has been selling us. So those of you who are trying to deceive Biafran people, hey, Nnamdi Kanu was arrested. Hey, wait, they give him 20 million. Oh, they give him all you wear. They ask him to carry Igbo State. Oh, is it all those cock and bull story? My guy, just forget about it. It's not going to work. We are watching all the negotiation that is going on. We are watching all the lies, all the deceit. And we can assure you as watchmen, Biafra watchmen for that matter, we will not allow anybody to sell the next generation of Biafra. It's a promise. And for the Nigerian state, I will assure you honestly that we all know how it's going to end. Nigeria must disintegrate. Those who take oath over their dead body that Nigeria must remain one, all of them are almost dying already. Their time is up already, and another generation must continue from where they stop. Those who are benefiting from Nigeria, we can assure you, you will still benefit. But then we must have our life back. That is just the whole issue that is at hand, that is on ground. And so I take this call and then we call it a day. Can you hear me call on the line?
Yeah, Mavi, the voice I draw clear, the network, I guess, we can't hear you at all.
You don't mean it. For how long have you noticed that?
We can't hear you for the past 10 minutes. Don't go in and I don't need to hear you at all, Mavi.
Oh, sorry for that. I think it should be from the last caller's network. Thank you for this update.
Yeah, and yes, you know. But the thing, bro, I'm going to read you at all.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Is that all?
Is that all?
I'm idiot, I agree. But we don't have name now. Don't you see how your brain function? You come in and say, hey, you idiot. When we tell the next generation about people like you, just look at you now. You can't even speak English. Now you can't speak English. Are we talking Igbo here? Are we talking English here? No, I don't understand what you are speaking. So are we talking Igbo here, Onyoshi? It's unfortunate. Is that all you have to say? You are calling from diaspora. You people are the one deceiving our people. You are calling from diaspora. But you don't have anything to say. Zumbi of Nnamdi Kanu. Yes, I just come to tell you that you are idiot. Why will we tell you? How can we tell you? You are calling from diaspora. You don't have name. You are ashamed. You want us to go and protest in Abuja when Nnamdi Kanu is collecting money. He go pepper on our well well. All of Unawe won't sell Igbo people. He go pepper on our well well. Look at you. Come down to Biafra land now and do your Biafra criminal.
Collect money from who?
I allow. Taking your number, you can't come home. I will profile you myself. Come home now.
You are a stupid man.
Come home now. You don't have document. You want to use our blood. Who are you? You are nobody. You don't have document where you are. Mention your name.
You are sabotaging
the struggle. Your name is what? Mention the full name.
Your father.
You don't have document, criminal. Maybe you are using fake number already. Is that all?
You don't see Ghana.
You are in Europe. Stop deceiving yourself. How can you be in Ghana?
When you see? People outside Nigeria. Outside
you, 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 You don't have what you are just a disgrace. You are not in Ghana. You are in Europe. Let me cut you off so that you know you are useless. You see, those Anandekano brainwash Mugu is calling from Europe. He's pretending he's in Ghana. You see them? These are the people. These are the kind of people who are in Europe deceiving some of you here in Biafra land to go and die for nothing.
You go and protest. You not agree. You protest.
Criminals. Look at them. You think when you call, you say you idiot, and then I feel bad. I don't feel bad. We know this disease already. Hello. Yes, caller on the line. Go ahead with what you have to say.
Good evening, sir. I'm calling from Calabar.
Good evening, my brother. Your name, please, and go ahead.
I'm Michael. Please, just leave. They should leave that man. That man is a foolish man.
He just behaves like a Nandekano. I know. That is exactly Nandekano behave.
He's a Nandekano. He's Nandekano. That they used to collect money and sell our people. He's an idiot. He's a foolish man.
But he doesn't know that our people are not happy on ground. Nandekano had deceived everybody, using paid agent to demoralize us, to oppress us. Nandekano, this thing will not end the way they think. That is one thing they don't know.
He's one of them. They were collecting money to be selling everybody.
We know now some of them be the children of devil. Nandekano is so wicked. It is so wicked. A soulless criminal.
Y'all bought all their brains.
A soulless individual using his people for ritual. And then some people are he's fighting for freedom. He's doing this one. Let him come out. Let us talk what we have put in this thing. You will see he was even the one feeding on our misery. And now those of them, now the money is not coming as they expect. They are getting angry. Thank you very much, my brother. We understand those games. We will not allow them to sell the next generation.
At all. It can happen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, good night from here. And of course, our people are awake. We know the truth. We tell ourselves the truth. We stand by the truth. You want us to tell you where before we start, we want to know how much Nandekano we collect. We want to know how this negotiation of amnesty Nandekano we collect. You think we are buying all those rubbish? He was in underground garage. They now lifted him to airport and he now went to buy pure water as he was going to temporary accommodation. And then they now called him and say it's Ashabat, Ashabua. You think we are buying into those rubbish? We're not. Just for the record purpose, all of you be telling your lies. You can imagine somebody in Europe calling he will idiot, he won't car. Is it today we start? This one and he just come newly safe. Letting us and Wolu come out and talk. What about us in Abanyim? All these real criminals, Chike Dozier. Where are all these criminals? Former, where are all the criminals? All these criminals, and then they carry innocent people like Nelson Tukara, Chris Ekan, all these innocent people, pack them, put inside DOS, they use them, they cover fees to the hard market. Those people know the truth already, but they just wish they can help remedy the situation. Very good. Always yoku na kune si obike. Mane zoku kasare zoku ubo na onye nwe mmadu ka onye nwe ego. Abunu agotane. Ewa zongwa kuko huwa liyongo. You are in Europe. You want to use our body to get documents. Come and bring the fight now. If I see you for Ghana. You don't catch Zumbi now. Say, you are calling from Ghana. Shame on you. You can't even mention your name. But you are the one going to give me order to go and protest. It's unfortunate anyway. And of course, I may have to leave the line for a bit longer for another zombie of Nnamdi Kanu to come. You can imagine, just two locations of this FM, Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station. The FM is just in two locations. You can imagine what will happen to you when we get everywhere. We told you, we warned you, but you thought you have monopoly over it. Just the same way we are begging Nigeria, let's dissolve this thing peacefully. We don't have to fight war again. We just don't have to. Then they think they have the monopoly, they control everywhere. We shall know who control who in the end. Which gave him Nnamdi Kanu all the support he need. We became his hand to reach the areas he cannot reach. We become his eyes to see areas he can't see. And at the end of the day, he call us a bluff. Onyemwoy, call on the line. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, my brother. Good evening.
Good evening from here. Your name and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from PH.
Go ahead, please.
How is your family?
God is faithful. He's helping us as always.
I can see. I love what they are doing. You know, it's very, very hard for people to understand. Especially people that are not closer to Nnamdi Kanu and the
Pastor. They don't know. People who are not close to Nnamdi Kanu, they are just looking at the lie this being dished out in the social media.
Yes, the ignorance of people this time, because of the trust and the love we have for this struggle, have made them to lose focus, to think very well that the characteristics of 419, 101% of the characteristics I know of a 419, that Nnamdi has it 101%. But when you begin to tell them, they will think that you are causing Nnamdi, wanting Nnamdi dead. I told one guy that Nnamdi have done his work and the past, and the spirit of Biafra have left him because he want to become God. God now bless. So what is holding Nnamdi there is called Agu. You know what is called Agu? Yes, the spirit of arrest. So Naim arrest him, carry and come here. What does all blah blah blah? I hear one of his lawyer in the social media, one of the BBC was interviewing him. He said that Kanu said that they carry him to private jet, but he somehow one color and there is no passenger there. The journalist asked him, how did he know that there is no passenger? Whereas he said that they blindfolded him. I was laughing. So what I'm trying to say this night, this is the first time I'm calling, is for those people that are listening, or those people that will listen after these broadcast. I myself am not contributing for any other thing than the truthful, not creating saboteur. I asked somebody, person will come for AK and the fight, come for Oli and the fight, come for Nkwa and the fight. Now, if they find market people trouble, I've been asking people to find them. You tell me, say, the person they find market people. You can say, Nnamdi, they find market people. Only in the sense. But what we know is that Biafra will come. That is what gives me joy. Biafra will surely come. So my brother, keep it on. It's not easy. People will not understand.
Thank you very much.
God will keep you, give you strength.
And you
most too. Especially in this critical time. In the end, Biafra will come.
You see?
I have Biafra.
All you Biafra. Thank you. The genuine people who followed Nnamdi Kanu at that initial stage to fight for Biafra, all of them know the truth. They have stand aside and they are watching. They may not come up now to speak, but it's a gradual process. We put our blood in this thing. There is absolutely nothing any of you can do. We only humble ourselves before the Creator. No more were you. Don't worry, you will get used to it. Yeah. Let's leave Nnamdi Kanu. No, they're not distracting. What is you people's plan? You think we are here to serve personality? Think we are here to deceive our people? So I talk to you and make you feel good. And then after feeling good, what else? It's unfortunate. Anyway, we draw the curtain on this segment. Tomorrow is another day. We will continue from where we stop. For the information of Nandekano recruit, we have not started. We are just warming up, testing the microphone. While we observe the social media barristers, those barristers who have turned Facebook to their courtroom, Barrister Geoffrey as well as Barrister Ejimakor, petition me, tell me the court to meet you. But of course you will not, all of you will not, because that will be the end of all of your career. 30 years behind your career, I will send you there to shock you. How many people will have to die? You think those people, you people led to their death? Barrister Geoffrey, do you know how many people they killed in your house? Those ones they burnt in those hillocks. Do you know their family don't know they are dead already, Barrister Geoffrey? How many of us more will you people sacrifice to fuel your ritual blood-tasty demons? Don't worry. We shall know who is a traitor. We shall know who is the betrayer of their people. We'll be leading them to their death, deceiving us. We will settle this matter holistically inside Biafra land before we continue. Those of you who are waking up already, I thank God for your life. May we never be compromised. Those of you who want to die in stupidity, may God grant your request on time. And for those who are ignorant, may He open your understanding, the eyes of your inner man, that you may be able to behold the wondrous truth in His word. I sign out from here. Remain blessed, remain Biafrans. Don't be discouraged. We will get home. They will know.
Adeo, hey, Mama Deo, Mama Deo, yeah. Abasi sasa mwale baba o, hey hey hey, boy come. Abasi sasa mwale baba o, hey hey hey, boy come. Nto eka jit pati
pati
sikidi
sikidi, hey hey hey, naibono toke kima kima rebio, oh oh, hey hey hey, pati pati pati
sikidi
sikidi sikidi,
abagi koro wan pati yo.
Sikedi,
Mbo
Bati,
Mbare ni Kamazon,
Sikedi,
Nsirata e Lesbien
Bati,
Nsiribom Batada,
Sikedi,
Nsirubom Batiyo,
Bati,
Obora Karapaimo,
Sikedi,
Wonderful people,
Bati.
One indigenous broadcaster championing the cause for the restoration of Biafra. Biafra Human Rights Radio. Of course, unstoppable and remains the beacon of truth. It has been so since yesterday, and it is today and forever.
Nai
bobon tebe ifia kera fono.
Isike ideyo. Nai bobon tebe ifia kima. Ibom adusat ibom inaiko. Kifon no ehe. Siyo kuba wamano yeneka from banpong ye. Isike ideyo.
Nai bobon tebe ifia keda fono.
Isike ideo. Nai bobon tebe ifia kima. Uyo ikwo ke kima. Iya itang mirem. Ida ikwa rambo. Ida ilegule gida raino basi kiro kangaji. Kop mi. Kop mi.
Project force. It remains sacrosanct. It is irreversible. And no amount of force can dampen nor quench the ingenuity and the resilience of the indomitable Biafran spirit.
Mm-hmm.